Stefano Tsitsipas off to a good start in this year's Italian Open. We'll see if he can continue to build on the success he's had so far on this year's clay season. Meanwhile, Novak Djokovic exits early again. He loses in another tournament early as he's out of this year's Italian Open. What's up, everybody? It's John Eric Poli here to go over rounds 3 and 4 from this year's Italian Open. In today's video, we'll be focusing on the men's side of things by going over the good, the bad, and the ugly. As always, we get started with the good, and I'm going with Stefano Tsitsipas. Tsitsipas looking good here in Rome, and shouldn't really come at too much of a surprise. He's looked very good on clay this year. He wins in Monte Carlo, finishes runner-up in Barcelona, had a bad showing in Madrid, but he was playing a lot of tennis in a short period of time. Maybe that early exit benefited him because he looks very good in this year's Italian Open, may even be the favorite in this year's tournament here going forward. Also, guys, want to give two quick honorable mentions here in the good category, and they're going to the two Americans, Tommy Paul, Taylor Fritz. Fritz just had a very good tournament in Madrid. He's continuing that success here. He moves into the quarterfinals here in the Italian Open. Also, Tommy Paul gets a big win over Daniil Medvedev. He's into the quarterfinals as well. Now we move on to the bad, and I'm going with Andrei Rublev here. Rublev just won the tournament in Madrid, had success on his side. Like I said before when I was doing a preview and prediction of this year's tournament, a lot of inconsistencies from Rublev. Here's another one here. After that great showing in Madrid, he exits early, losing in round 3 of this year's Italian Open. And with Rublev losing, I mean, how much worse could it possibly get for anybody out there after everything that he just did? Well, that's why we go to the ugly in today's video. We're going with Novak Djokovic, one of the most accomplished players of all time. Many people consider him the greatest of all time. And now he loses early again here in 2024. Very bad showing for Novak Djokovic here in this year's Italian Open. And with all the injuries out there, right? Jannik Sinner injured, Carlos Alcaraz injured. We have inconsistencies at times from Tsitsipas, from Rublev, from Alexander Zverev. I thought this was a great opportunity for Novak Djokovic to cash in and make a run here in 2024. Fails to do so, losing in round 3. Very bad showing by Novak Djokovic. And it is officially time to worry if you're on Novak Djokovic's team here, because a lot of signs of concern here. Things just continue to get worse for Novak. Hopefully he's able to bounce out of it at some point. And if he's going to do it for the French Open, he better do it soon, because that tournament is literally right around the corner here. So that was the recap of rounds 3 and 4 from this year's Italian Open. We'll have more coverage of the event right here.